candidate for harpsichord here. But this is not harpsichord, this is a hurdy-gurdy. The hurdy-gurdy is about 1,000 years old this year, probably, maybe, you know, just give or take. It was in use in Europe from about the 10th or 11th centuries. The originals were very, very long. It took one person at one end to crank, and the other person, the other act, to hit the keys. They've developed in a myriad of different ways, and they've been used a lot of different ways throughout the centuries. The music that we're playing today is from the 18th century, from the early 18th century, where the hurdy-gurdy enjoyed a renaissance in Paris salons. Instruments, nasal and pastoral instruments, like the hurdy-gurdy and the musette, which is a small bagpipe, they enjoyed a very a flowering in this time, where French Parisian nobles like to imagine themselves as country people living simple lives, culminating in maybe Marie Antoinette living in a hammock where servants clean the eggs before she found them. That's sort of the finish of this. Really quickly, it is basically a cranked violin. There is a wheel here on a rod, and it draws across strings. Some strings don't change pitch, and are drum strings. Other strings called chanterelles. And so those are controlled, the pitch is controlled by tangents down here, and they, as you go up, they bend the pitch of the string. So this sonata is from, I think, about the 1730s. Philibert, Delavigne, who many of us have never heard his music before. So this could be a long, long-time premiere of Delavigne, for all we know.